Welcome to The Math Planet, your fast math guide. Hi everyone, I'm Bidis. Today, I'm going to give you a brief introduction to Abacus Math. So, let's get started. Hello my dear friends, my name is Bidis. In this video, I will introduce the Japanese abacus or soroban. You will learn about the main parts of the Japanese abacus. You will also know how to represent numbers on it. Hello everyone! This is the Japanese abacus. The main parts of it are as follows. We have this border, which is called the frame. So this is the frame of the abacus. Then we got some columns. These columns are called rods. On each rod you will find four lower beads and one upper bead. And then we got also a divider line that separates the lower beads from the upper beads. This divider line is called the bar. On this bar you will find some points. These points are column indicators. For example, the point in the middle of the abacus signals that this rod is the unit's rod, so it's called the unit point. So if this is the unit's rod, so the rod to the left of it will be the tens rod, then hundreds rod, then this is the thousands rod, and so on. Again, unit's rod is in the middle, this is the tens rod, hundreds rod and thousands rod, and so on. What about the other rods to the right side? These are all decimal rods. So you will reset the abacus like this using your thumb and index fingers. Okay, you will use the thumb to count the lower beads. You will use the index finger for the upper beads. We said that the unit's rod is the one on the middle, so this is how you count 1, this is how you represent 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. So you notice that the lower beads each has a value of 1, while the upper bead has a value of 5. Okay, so this is 5, and this is how you make 6. This is how you make 7, it's 5 and 2. This is how you make 8, and this is how you make 9. To make 10, you will reset the unit's rod and move 1 bead up on the tens rod. Okay, so this is 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. This is 60, 70, 80, 90, and to make 100, you will move to the hundreds rod. Okay, now let's reset.
Let's sum up today's lesson. The main parts of the abacus are the frame, the rods, the upper beads, the lower beads, the bar, and the points, the most important of which is the unit point, which is in the middle of the bar. This is how you represent 0. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So, that's all for today. Thanks for watching the Math Planet. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe for more videos. See you in the next video. Bye!